The man who led authorities on two stolen vehicle chases in New Mexico and then escaped from a hospital is now in custody. The Bernalillo County Sheriff's Office tells us Jason Smith was arrested last night at a gas station near Kernowell. Smith escaped from UNM Hospital Tuesday. Smith was arrested and taken to the hospital on December 10th after crashing when he fled from deputies for the second time in as many days. We'll have more on this later in the show at 6:30. And police say two Grinches admitted to robbing a home on Christmas morning. Santa Fe police say they watched Matthew Gomez and Ashley Roybal push a stolen television out of their car. When asked about the TV, they said they didn't want to be caught with it. Police say the burglars would knock on doors to see if people were home before breaking and entering. They say they did it to get more drugs. A suspected drunk driver crashes into some parked cars right in front of a police officer. It happened just after 11 last night. Albuquerque police say a sergeant was working near San Pedro in northeast Albuquerque when he saw a gray Subaru speeding and driving recklessly. The sergeant went after the driver, but when he got behind the car, police say the driver of the Subaru lost control, crashing into two parked cars. That driver has been arrested. Police say alcohol does appear to be a factor in the crash. Santa Fe police have identified the pedestrian who was hit and killed on Christmas Eve. They say 33-year-old Abel Martinez of Santa Fe was not in the crosswalk when he was hit on Cerrillos and Siler Road about 7:30 Wednesday night. Police also say Martinez was in dark clothing and may have been wearing headphones. The driver is cooperating with police and most likely will not be charged, but the crash is under investigation. A very somber holiday for NYPD officers. The wake was held yesterday for Officer Rafael Ramos, one of two officers killed in an ambush shooting last week. This is a live picture outside of Christ Tabernacle Church in New York City, where people are filing in for Ramos's funeral today. As CBS's Marley Hall reports, thousands, including the vice president, are expected to attend.
Mourners from across New York City and the country waited into the night to pay respect to police officer Rafael Ramos.
It's a shame that we get together when a tragedy like this takes place, but we have to show our support.
Ramos and his partner, Officer Wenjin Liu, were shot and killed in their patrol car last Saturday near a Brooklyn housing project. Fellow officers carried Ramos's casket into his church as hundreds looked on.
He was studying to be a pastor, so he had books on how to be a pastor and Bible study books in his locker. That just goes to show you the type of man he was.
Ramos's funeral will be held Saturday. Vice President Biden is expected to attend. The church seats about 800, but thousands of police officers from across the U.S. and Canada are expected here as well.
The shooting highlighted tension between police and New York Mayor Bill de Blasio. Earlier in the day, a banner reading, "De Blasio, our backs have turned to you," was flown over the Hudson River. Ramos's pastor asked mourners to pray for his family.
Like I said, he was a man of great faith, and his faith informed his worldview, not just as a police officer, but as a husband. And as a father.
Officer Ramos leaves behind a wife and two sons. Marley Hall, CBS News, Queens, New York.
A New Mexico Health Department supervisor says she suffered backlash when she spoke up about wrongdoing in the department. The Santa Fe New Mexican reports Amber Espinosa Trujillo filed a whistleblower lawsuit in court this week. The suit claims her superiors purposely understaffed an area that certifies healthcare facilities to get more money from Medicaid and says instead they hired private contractors at rates more than twice what a regular state employee would cost. The department has declined to comment on the allegations. State regulators will start discussing a controversial proposal soon. It calls for shutting down part of an aging coal-fired power plant in San Juan County. But one environmental group, New Energy Economy, is calling for Public Regulation Commissioners Pat Lyons and Karen Montoya to recuse themselves from the deliberations. They argue that phone calls and emails between PNM and the two commissioners have created an appearance of a conflict of interest. The proposal for shutting down part of the San Juan Generating Station is aimed at meeting certain pollution standards. However, it has drawn criticism from environmentalists who who say PNM's reliance on fossil fuels would still be too high. Suspect who gave police the slip more than once is behind bars. Doctors and deputies both thought Jason Smith was too hurt to even walk. BCSO found out the hard way how wrong they were, and now they say they won't be fooled again. Smith was originally arrested by BCSO after deputies say he rammed several patrol cars over the span of 2 days. He crashed into a ravine the second time, and deputies took him to UNM Hospital. His injuries appeared significant enough that doctors told BCSO Smith couldn't sit up and would need to spend weeks in rehab before he could walk. So deputies decided not to guard him 24 hours a day, only checking in on him occasionally.
That was an assessment that we made based on the medical advice, that I made based on the medical advice. And obviously, in retrospect, Mr. Smith is a pretty good actor, apparently.
It turns out Smith could walk, which he did, right out of the hospital. Deputies say he stole a van and evaded UNM police. It took deputies 3 days to track Smith down again. They tell us they nabbed him in another stolen truck last night near Tramway and Central. This time, Smith was taken straight to MDC. Deputies say they're still looking into how Smith escaped UNM Hospital and will review their policy on how they guard suspects who need medical care. He faces a string of charges, including aggravated assault and aggravated fleeing from law enforcement. Investigators are asking the public for help in a Christmas Eve murder mystery in Southwest Albuquerque. Bernalillo County Sheriff's deputies were called out after the body of 26-year-old Idali Reyes was found in front of a home near Five Points. Deputies say she died from blunt force trauma and puncture wounds. And police are looking into who may have shot and killed a man in Northeast Albuquerque. They say they were called out on a suspicious person's call yesterday afternoon. When police got there, a man told them he was worried about his neighbor. That's when police found a man with a gunshot wound dead inside a house. Police are working on identifying that man. Stay with KRQE as we follow this developing story. An Arizona couple accused of dumping a body at the Albuquerque Sunport will face trial separately. Authorities say Laura Stale Musick and Marzit Ferris of Prescott drove to Albuquerque back in 2011 and left a van parked at the Sunport for days. Inside the van was the body of Stale Musick's husband, Craig. He had been stabbed multiple times. Stale Musick and Ferris had dated in college and had reportedly reconnected over the internet. They were both arrested in North Carolina 9 days after the body was found. A judge ruled the couple will not be tried together after the defense argued they could implicate each other in front of a jury. Ferris's trial is scheduled to start next month. No word when Stale Musick's is set to start. Former Rio Arriba County Sheriff Tommy Rodella will have to wait to find out how long he'll serve behind bars. Rodella faces between 7 and 17 years in prison when he's sentenced in federal court January 21st. He was supposed to be sentenced yesterday, but because of the holiday court closure, it was moved. Rodella roughed up a driver during a traffic stop and violated his rights. The feds are seeking a strict sentence, saying Rodella abused his power for 2 decades and got away with it. Meanwhile, Rodella is fighting for a new trial. A Durango man has been arrested, accused of holding a woman hostage for days, repeatedly beating her. La Plata County Sheriff's deputies say they were called out to a home early Christmas Eve. That's when they found a woman barely conscious. Deputies say she told them 46-year-old Edward Venturoso held her against her will and hit her with a cast iron frying pan. They say he then broke her phone so she couldn't call for help and assaulted her over the next 2 days. The victim was taken to the hospital for treatment. Venturoso is being held now on felony charges.